Thank you for the introduction, Elena. Now let's talk about happiness. John Lennon gave us some wise advice saying that happiness is one of the most important things in our lives. From day to day, we spend most of our time working. Our job has a great influence on how we feel. So what makes us happy at work? Usually, people tend to think that leadership is characterized by extreme levels of stress, that chief executive officers and top management are the least happy people in the company. However, it's not always true. In 2012, the US National Academy of Sciences published a very interesting work called "Leadership is Associated with Lower Levels of Stress." The results of the study showed that if leaders also experience a heightened sense of control, then leadership should be associated with reduced stress levels. The thing is that sense of control is a psychological factor known to have powerful stress buffering effect. Using the unique examples of real leaders, including military officers and government officials, they found that compared with non-leaders, leaders had lower levels of the stress hormone cortisol and less reports of anxiety. Also, leaders holding more powerful positions exhibited lower cortisol levels and less anxiety than leaders holding less powerful positions, a relationship explained by the fact that of their greater sense of control. Altogether, these findings reveal a clear correlation between leadership and stress, with leadership level being inversely related to stress level. Another interesting study was published in the Journal of Occupational and Organizational Psychology in 2003. The research examined the impact of illusory control beliefs on the performance of the traders in financial instruments. The data collected from 107 traders from four different companies trading on a fictional computer-simulated market showed that traders having strong illusion of control perform less effectively. Traders not having such strong beliefs were less happy, but they achieved greater results. After years of software testing experience, we are sure that testing does not intend to make people happy. Testing intends to tell people the truth. The harsh reality is that when project managers look at different positive metrics and indicators of their project, they feel comfort. But this comfort is just an illusion. Traceability matrices built during the fast-paced development lifecycle do not tell you the full truth about your coverage. Very often, QA teams are forced to write test scripts only to meet newly added changes, rather than prepare well-analyzed and tense scenarios. No doubt that most of the bugs are found in the new areas of the product, but the behavior of the user always consists of a long chain of events. Only such scenarios can build a really strong regression library with really strong quality characteristics. That is why you cannot work only to provide metrics and indicators. First of all, you should assure their quality. Software testing team assures the quality by uncovering the hidden. We combine knowledge and the desire to reveal what is unknown. We believe that machine learning and data science can transform the approaches of the past into new sophisticated testing techniques. Traceability matrices focusing on small subsets of data are gone. Exactpro has built a test database that we call Cradle. It's a framework that allows us to store the data from hundreds and thousands of test nodes. We do not just collect only pass-fail outcomes for each test execution, but also network traffic, log files, system configuration files, defects, and etc. It's like a black box on a plane. The raw data is converted into sets of flat files that are structured in a form that can be accessed by distributed queries. Instead of running a single test case per requirement, Cradle allows us to perform compliance checks as analytical queries, again, the whole set of the database. Software testers are often expected to make people happy, but that's up to some other jobs. We are here to be sincere with our clients and stand tall together.